You might have run into this. You have an application running locally on your local machine that is behind your router, and it works fine, obviously, but this is an internal IP address. So what do you say? Okay, I want to try this from my mobile phone, which is running on 4G. It's in an external network, right? So obviously it doesn't work. So what do you think? It's like, okay, what's my public IP address, right? And then you get that public IP address and you try, okay, let me just do that, right? And it gives you an error, right? And that's a legit error because your router is not running port 222. Your application on your Mac or your laptop is running that application, right? So what you want to do is you have so many options to do this, and we discussed some of them on another video. I'm going to reference video. One way is to do a port forwarding on your router. You go physically to your router admin page and you do, okay, when someone connect to port 2222, please connect it to this machine, okay? But there is another way, a more elegant way, if you will, right, using another protocol called UPNP, which stands for Universal Plug and Play. And what this does, essentially, it's a client that you install in your laptop, and it talks to a router, to your router, and it will ask the router to open a port, right? And that's a protocol that some routers support. So in my router, for example, here, if I go to my router and then go to firewall, you can see that my router actually supports UPNP and it's enabled. And I can choose to disable this thing. So if you want your application to actually ask the router to open a specific port for you, you can enable this thing. Okay, you can enable this on your router. And some peer-to-peer network uses actually this technology, like a torrent, like how torrent works, right? It's listening on something on your machine, and it allows other people to connect to your server, and it allows it is able to do that by asking the router to open specific ports for external traffic to flow in. All right, so that's what we're going to discuss in this video, right? So if you're interested, stay tuned. So what we're going to do here is, first we're going to install the UPNP client on my local machine. So I know that my router supports UPNP, so I'm good there. So the next step is we go to my machine and install the UPNP client. And there is a light mini UPNP client that I found, and I'm going to reference it below. For Mac, you can just do brew. If you have a homebrew, you can just install that. So that's what I'm going to do now. All right, so for Mac, I'm going to have the link below for the mini UPNP client. But if you have homebrew, you can just do this. Brew install mini UPNP C, which stands for client. So mini UPNP client, right? And then once you install that, you will have access to the UPNPC command prompt. Sweet. So I have it installed. So what you need to do is very, very simple. Okay. So now if you do UPNPC, you can see that I have actually it's running, right? So that's the command we want to use. All right. So let's use this little bit of the client library to actually open an external port to our internal application. So what I'm going to do is you're going to do UPNPC, okay? And you want to add dash A. And this is the rule you want to add. You want to add a rule. And everything forwarded to your machine, right? 192.168.254.10. So that's my local IP address of my Mac that is my application is running on. And the next parameter is, which port is your application running to? It's running on port 2222, okay? And the final thing is, what port do you want me to open on the router so I can forward the traffic to your application, which is running on 2222? And you can do anything you want. So I'm gonna choose 7777 just to show you the example here, okay? And finally you do a space and then you do this protocol. Usually we're working with TCP. Despite my application is actually HTTP, might as well just use a low level TCP. And as you can see, guys, we have successfully redirected everything that goes to my public IP address, which is this guy, on port 777 to my application on port 2222 internally. How about we test this thing? So I'm gonna go to my public IP address. That's my public IP address. If you don't know, just Google it. It will tell you what's your public IP address. Google will tell you, right? And then you do 7777, right? That's the port. And here's Michael Scott. So I can send this application, this URL to anyone and it will work, right? And make sure, guys, to delete that rule if you no longer need it. And I'm gonna show you how to delete it in a minute now. So like you've tested your application, you're good. You don't want anyone to access your public IP address, right? So what you want to do is essentially go and delete that rule. So how about we delete that rule? So it's very simple to do. It's UPNPC, okay? Whether you are on Windows or Mac, it's the same exact command, right? So dash D is deleting a port mapping. So dash D. And what port? What is the external port? I don't care about your internal port. My external port is 777. And that's the only thing you need, right? And obviously you need to specify which protocol because you can have multiple. And then go ahead and delete that. And once you're done, it's done, right? So we removed that, we popped it out. So now, if someone tries to access 777, that should just go away. So let's go ahead and try that. So let's go ahead and open a brand new incognito mode, and then hit that, and you can see that I can no longer access that port externally, right? All right, guys, hope you enjoyed this short video. I'm gonna see you in the next one. So UPNP, be careful of this, really. A lot of routers actually disable this by default because if an application can run on your machine and it can communicate with the router to ask it to open port, that could be dangerous, right? And I know that peer-to-peer application like WebRTC and peer-to-peer like torrent actually relies on UPNP to be open, right? And I can show you an example here, hopefully in the B-roll, right? So an application can ask the router to open a port, and that's okay, right? As long as the router supports that thing, okay? So it's up to you. If you don't want application to access external traffic to access you directly, applications running directly, like whether this is any application, doesn't have to be a web server, right? Like a remote control, like a RDP, remote desktop control, SSH, anything really can be exposed as long as you add the port mapping. And what we learned before is like you add the port mapping physically by going to the port mapping port forwarding on the router. But this is like an easiest way for you hackers out there. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. I'm gonna see you in the next one. Stay awesome.